Hello and welcome. In this video, we're going to use NotebookLM as a major part of the process of turning an MP4 into a slide presentation. You are now watching an MP4 and the sound is turned down in that MP4, and it is a step-by-step and over-the-shoulder video tutorial. This is the video that we are going to use in order to turn into a slide presentation using NotebookLM. First part of the process involves you taking MP4 and turning it into screenshots or PNG files. We're first going to ask Gemini in order to undertake this process. We're going to give the command to turn the MP4 into PNG screenshots at 5-second intervals. We will then click Submit. Gemini does attempt, but does not result in delivering PNG files. We're going to try the same process in ChatGPT, and we're going to use the same prompt. So we have in a simple prompt, we are now going to click enter. We're assuming that this process is going to take time. If you do want to watch the process, you can click this down arrow and you can see what Python is doing in order to produce your request. However, what we're going to do is we're going to stop the video here. We're going to pick it up from the completion of the request, whether ChatGPT decides to create the PNG files or whether or not it determines that it cannot. So we told ChatGPT we did not see the folder. ChatGPT does return to us a folder and says it has given us the PNG files and has given us 62 files. And when we unzip our files, we now have them here in this area. We're now going to open up a new NotebookLM notebook. We are now going to upload the PNG files. Files are now uploaded. We are now going to upload a video transcript, video time transcript, and video summary. The only two items we can upload are a video summary, which is a TXT file, and the video summary, which is a Word document. What we are now going to do is we're going to go over to the slide deck, and we're going to ask for presenter slides. We're now going to ask for the default length, and we're going to ask for NotebookLM to produce step documents detailing the process outlined in the summary and transcript and to use the PNG files. So we're now going to ask for one PNG file per slide, one text file, and then the docx file. And we're going to ask for a sequential document outlining the process explained. We are now going to generate using the slide deck. Now, this process is not going to be instantaneous, so we're going to stop the video here, and we're going to wait to pick it up from the completion of this slide deck. Our slide deck is now complete. We can now click the slide deck. It isn't quite 64 and does use the PNGs in order to put together the presentation. We're going to try the process again. We're going to use the other kind of slide presentation. We're going to view the custom prompt. We're going to copy it. And this time, what we're going to do is go to the slide deck. We're going to ask for a detailed deck. We're going to use the default length. We're going to use the same prompt. And this time, we are then going to generate another slide deck. And once again, we're going to allow this process to complete. And we'll stop the video and come back when it is complete. And our second slide presentation is now complete, and we'll now look at that slide presentation. Now, the presentation does indeed use some of the PNG files. It isn't as long as we might like, but it does use the assets. And since a detailed deck produces a slightly better output, we're going to go ahead and get the entire custom prompt again. And since with NotebookLM, less is more, we're going to try something different this time. This time, we're not going to use the summary. We're only going to use the transcript. And so what we're going to do here is we're going to go to the slide deck. We're going to use a detailed deck. We're going to use the very same prompt. We're going to take out that we want to use the summary. And we're going to ask for a sequential step document outlining the process explained. We are now going to click generate. And we're going to await this process to complete. We're going to stop the video here. We're going to pick it up from the completion of this step document. And the third guide is now complete. So you'll want to test to see which document gives you the results that you want for your audience. But basically, you have now a process that you can use in order to take any MP4 video and the visuals within that MP4 into a step document in a slide deck using NotebookLM. Okay, so with that, thanks, and I will see you in another video.